I've got a practice exercise for you that you can do over and over and over again to gain experience, confidence, and while you're practicing, you may come up with questions or things that you may think, oh, that's a good trick, or that's a good tip, or that's a good strategy. And that is all about using a sample company, a list of expenses and list of income for a sample or a dummy company that you can then practice with. And downloading transactions, you can download transactions that you make up or download transactions from your own bank activity or from a sample company. Usually whatever accounting or bookkeeping software system that you are using will have access to a sample company. And accessing that sample company, you can access the chart of accounts or the list of income and expenses, and you can access a certain amount of transactions for you to practice with. And before you even get into QuickBooks Online, QuickBooks Desktop, Xero, Wave, FreshBooks, whatever accounting software system you're going to be using for your bookkeeping business, before you do any of that, I would encourage you to try to do this in a Google Sheet or Excel, whichever spreadsheet you prefer. That is the one that you're going to use for you to start practicing. To start your exercise, you need two things. The first one is you need a list of your accounts, your income and expenses. We're not going to get into the whole balance sheet and income statement right now. We're going to keep it simple. We're going to pretend that this client came to you and has maybe like a certain amount of months worth of transactions in their bank account that they need to categorize in order for them to generate a financial statement. This is a real scenario that will happen in your bookkeeping business. And so I want to make sure that you know how to start gathering this data. And oftentimes, this is a little bit of a it's a bonus tip. But oftentimes when you're using a system, let's say it's QBO or QuickBooks Desktop, you can actually create this spreadsheet in a way that you can then download it. You know, you come up with all the elements that you need for that data, the date, the name of the vendor, the transaction, the memo, the amount. Anyway, you get all that and then you download it as a CSV file and then you go into your accounting software system and you can upload it. But I will show you that in a more advanced video training, okay? For today, all we're going to do is come up with a practice sample company. So you're the first thing, like I said, you need your list of accounts, your income and expenses. And then you're going to need a file with a lot of data transactions. And you can do this one of two ways. You can look into whatever software system you have access to, if you do have access to any, and look for a sample company. And oftentimes they will have not only a list of accounts, but they will also have a certain, like a bank account, a checking account with a lot of sample transactions. If you can download those two, now you've got what you need in order to start practicing. Now, if you don't have access to that, what you could do is you could download your own bank account activity. Whatever bank you bank with, wherever you keep your checking, savings, money, go ahead and download those transactions for a certain amount of months. And then once you do that, kind of come up with just some sample income and expense account categories that you're going to then look at every single line item and transaction and categorize each one of them. If you can't quite picture this, don't worry. I'm going to take you over to my desktop in just a few moments and we're going to start practicing there. Again, you need a list of accounts, that is your income and expenses, and then you're going to need a sample data file of a lot of different transactions that we can then practice categorizing. One file, two tabs. I'm going to show you step by step on how to do this and how to set it up so that you can start practicing today. But before we do, I'm Veronica Sagastimi, and I want to welcome you to the Profitable Bookkeeping Biz channel. This is the place where I'm going to be sharing my tips, tricks, best strategies, and practices that you can adopt for your own profitable bookkeeping business, because that's what I want for you. I want you to make a profit right from the very beginning. All right, here we are at my desktop, and here's where I'm going to show you the two items that I was telling you that you need. The first is an account list, and this is a full account that I got from a sample company out of QuickBooks Desktop. Now, again, you might want to check whatever system you use for your bookkeeping or you're thinking about using to see if they have sample client files, because if they do, it's a great way for you to practice. But I'm going to walk you through how to practice outside of the accounting system, because even though the accounting system helps you to do a lot of that, it's always good for you to know how to do so in a spreadsheet, whether it's Google Sheets or Excel. All right. So here back at my computer, what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn off my video so we can focus on just the data on the file instead of you guys looking at me. Okay, here we go. All right. So as you can see, I have exported what we call the chart of accounts. And this is just a list of a lot of different accounts that this sample business may use. In the case of this sample business, we are going to be looking at, I believe that this is a gardening or a gardener that is a small business. And we are looking at, again, you can see this is very clearly a sample company. It's in the future. And I downloaded all of the transactions from January 1st of that year. If we scroll down, there really isn't a lot of transactions. And so we got a full year's worth. Listen, I'm giving you this because it is not unusual for clients to come to you, especially during tax time, that they haven't done their bookkeeping for the entire year. And so the very first thing that we would want is to download all of their banking transactions by account. As you can see, he's got a few other ones here, cash expenditure, savings, barter account. And so back in the chart of accounts, if you look, it's like checking, cash expenditures, savings, barter account. So these would be the four bank accounts that we would want to have access to. But for the purposes of this exercise and for your future practice exercise, you want to usually just kind of really focus on one of these accounts. And I would typically say it's the business checking account. Now, just to scroll down very quickly, you have your typical accounts. You have your accounts receivable for invoicing. I don't want to get too much into the chart of accounts because I can do a future video just explaining all of these different accounts. For purposes of categorizing the cash activity, we're going to focus on the income accounts. This is all types of income that he can have. This is the cost of goods. You know, there could be a lot of different things that's categorized as cost of goods. And here are his different expenses. Again, this is a sample company. Don't get too caught up in what all of these mean. We're going to keep it simple to start with. We can always get fancy later, all right? Let's just pretend that this is a very simple business and we're just going to be looking at cash. Again, this is our bank account here. We're going to pick a couple of, let's just say that these are the main three income accounts that we're going to have. And we may have a cost of goods. Cost of goods is any cost that's directly related to delivering that service. This is a service provider, is a gardener. And then these are the types of expenses. But, you know, we're not going to be doing everything that is listed here. I just want you to know that this is what's available for this type of business. Yours could be even shorter than this. It really is that simple. Now, when we go to the actual transactions, when I export that, I don't like to override the original. What I like to do is after I have downloaded the original transactions, and it could just be maybe you want to practice with 1 month at a time, and that's okay. I'm right clicking. I say move or copy. I'm going to create a copy and I want it after here. I'm going to say okay. And see, it says number two. So here I'm just going to put January. I'm going to label January 2025. I can do that. I can either hide all the rows or I can just delete. And I don't want anything else. I basically just want to show you how you can export everything, have it ready to go. And then you're able to just have your working file, one tab for each month. So let me go ahead and pause for a moment while I... All right. So all I've done is once I copied over all of our data here, I renamed the tab by right-clicking and just renaming it for the month. And then I deleted everything that came after January 31st that redid the total. So as you can see, this is capturing the right rows. And I did a quick check here. I just did my beginning balance plus my cash in minus cash out. And that matches. So now I know that I have all of my data here. And what I want to do is, you know, some of these things I don't actually need. So I'm going to just, I'm not going to delete. I'm just going to hide. And then here is where I'm going to maybe, yeah, I think in do it in this column, I'm going to put category. And if you don't want to say category, you can say type. And all of this is like, or account. Category or account type. Any of those will do. But basically, this is what you're going to be using your chart of accounts. And typically, you know, we have this in front of us, or I have two monitors. The chart of account is on one, and then the spreadsheet is on the other. I go ahead and I look at each one, and I would categorize it based on that spread, on that chart of accounts. And so a lot of times you may feel like, oh, I don't need all those accounts. And you really don't. You may want to skim through this. And right away, we know that these are the three types of income that we have. And we know that the debit column of a checking account, when we export it, it is pretty much the deposits, unless it's an adjustment. And so if we look at this, let's just kind of say this is a deposit, and we're going to say that this is a landscaping service. Okay. And so we're just going to copy and paste this. And this next one, it says Walker Rich. Let's just kind of think, oh, maybe this is for design services. Okay. And we have one more. And again, you're just practicing. And this is going to be another payment. And let's just say that this was for equipment rental. Again, if it helps to copy and paste it here, that is okay. If that's what you want, you don't need it, because if you have a dual monitor, you could be copying and pasting from the other monitor here. And so then what you want to do is, even though there is a sum here, there's no formulas. If you wanted to do a formula very quickly, you could just do plus the beginning balance, plus the debit, minus the credit, and then drag it down. And that should give you the 190.104. This way, I'm going to show you that I'm going to actually save this file. And yes, if I wanted to start sorting, but I don't want to distort the balance, I can put the category here. And let me show you what I mean by that. So let's say I'm ready to put all of the income, and none of these things say income. So I would probably put something like this, income. When you have 1 month, it's not a lot of data, it's not a big deal. But when you have a whole year worth of transactions, and then you start to group things together and you group them by category, well, then it makes a big deal. This makes a big difference when you are consistent with the type. You would income would be income colon and then the type, and expense would be EXP colon and then the type of category. So let's say right now I already want to lump, or you know, group all of that data together. So I'm going to sort, and I'm going to sort by column Z, and it's going from A to Z. So that's good. That's what I want. So see how the balance stayed the same, because it recalculated, but now I've got all of my income together, and then I've got everything else. And if I wanted to do that for the expenses so that it's easier, so I can get on a roll, I would go to data again. Oops, let me go to data. I would sort. And instead of sorting by Z, I'm going to sort by name. And then I'm going to add another one. I'm going to click this plus sign, and I'm going to sort by date, which would be G. So that way, if I have more than one vendor or payee that's got the same name, like in this one, Great State Bank, then it's puts it in date order for me. All right. So now I'm going to go and take a look at the type of expense. And again, I'm kind of making these up because I just want to show you as an example. I would be constantly referencing what my expenses would be and then categorizing them accordingly. So I'm going to go ahead, and for all of these, I'm going to say expense, because then it'll group and then it'll say the category. And so for all of these, I'm just going to do that. And now I can just very easily, you see how I've got a space in there? I'm going to get rid of this space. And I could say anything. For example, that could be utilities, to keep it simple. And let me stop recording for a moment, and I'm going to go grab some of those expense accounts right now. All right. So now in looking at the transactions here, I could determine that some of these were utilities, some of these were paychecks, others were bank service fee, costs of goods. And I think I said, we're going to pretend like this is rent. So very quickly, you can see Bayshore Water. We're going to say, okay, it's utilities, and it's utilities water. So we're going to be very specific with that type of expense. So again, remember we said it's going to be expense, and then utilities water. And then the next one is Cal Gas Electric. We can see that there is an actual rent account like that. And we can do that, copy and paste, Cal Telephone. We can see that that is going on here. just, you can just see that it's, as long as you have a few things in place, you start to see it's the same things over and over again. Now for the payroll, for the paychecks, they just have a payroll account. I would probably have a little bit more detail, but for purposes of this exercise, you are just going to use the expense accounts that this sample company has, and all they have is payroll. So I'm going to be like, oh no, I went too far. So I'm going to delete that. But you know what? I see a few more paychecks down here. So I'm going to go ahead and categorize those already, because that way I'm done. You see how quickly I'm going? And then I think this one is going to be rent. I see it down there. And this one's going to be bank service charges. And last but not least, I see this is going to be expense. Now I did this on purpose. Don't call me out yet. I did this on purpose. So the cost of goods is right there. We're going to go ahead and paste it right here, and we're done. Now within these, what we want to do now is we want to do data, sort, and we want to group it by Z and then the date. Okay, so see how everything here is very uniform. It says expense, cost of goods, payroll expense, rent, utility, gas, telephone, water. But this bank service charge, you know, kind of sticks out, right? And so if you look at the chart of accounts, we can see it's cost of goods, payroll expense, bank service charge, rent, and then utilities. So we definitely want to put the expense. We want to be consistent because it's going to help us in the long run to really be starting to identify. That's it. Identify all of these. Now, in a future video, I will show you how you can subtotal these, especially if you have more than 1 month. But for purposes of this, I would love for you to start practice. Get a sample data file, get your chart of accounts, and you can even make this up and download your own bank transactions. Okay, so let me come back online. Okay, you guys. So for purposes of this video, it is all about having you practice so that you can feel confident, gain experience, know the type of category or the account type, the expense and the income category that you're going to give every single transaction that is linked to a bank account. So that when a client comes to you and says, hey, I need you to help me get caught up, not only will you have every single month categorized, but also this helps you to reconcile the bank accounts as well. And even though I will help you to know how to do this inside of an accounting software system or bookkeeping software system like QuickBooks Online or QuickBooks Desktop, it is always really good for you to know the exact same thing we just did here for Excel. You can do so with Google Sheets. Again, the two things that you need a list of accounts, mostly income and expense, so you can practice, and you need a sample data bank file, something that you can download from a bank transaction. Go and look at your accounting software system, see if you have a sample data file, and just have fun with it. And again, as long as you don't do anything with the original, you can always copy and paste and do 1 month at a time, or you can do the whole year at a time if you want. But you can see that for a lot of times, what I will do is I will hide columns that I don't need, but I will insert the column that I do need just to be consistent. I do the exact same thing. And you already saw how you can always have the running balance. You can do the beginning balance, and then you can have a plus beginning, plus the debit, which is cash in, minus credit, which is the cash out, and that gives you your running ending balance. And when you do a data sort, do not include your column. If you have found this video valuable, please consider subscribing, give me a thumbs up, and ring that bell so that you can be notified the next time that I publish another helpful bookkeeping business video. Until next time, I'm Veronica. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comments. I would love to hear from you. And that's it for now. I will see you next week. Same time, same place. Bye for now.